Vendor records are maintained not only to store contact and billing information, but also allow for defining purchase order preferences and exploring historical purchase transactions. Some information of typical interest can be found on the Address tab for billing and remit to addresses, and the Order defaults for how purchase orders are shipped. The Billing tab displays credit terms and bank information for electronic fund transfers. Special vendor prices for items can be set if they are purchased within a given date range or quantity ordered, different than the most recent cost of the item. Vendors can have an active status to allow purchase order entry, or inactive to prevent this. In addition to vendor information, you can also see the outstanding accounts payable for paying invoices, and see the list of open or historical purchase orders, perhaps to locate a particular order and drill down to open the transaction screen. There are a few other records that should be defined as you maintain your vendors and customers. From the Edit menu, payment terms are used to calculate the due date, discount date, and amount for vendor and customer invoices, so that overdue invoices can be aged and early payment discounts can be determined. Sales taxes are used to define tax jurisdiction rates and accounting for vendors and customers, in conjunction with inventory tax statuses to determine tax amounts on transactions, if Avalara or other third-party tax calculations are not used. And there are a wide range of options and configurations and default values across all Spire modules that can be set up either company-wide or through user security settings.